Good morning, students of class 10. You are welcome back to the classes now. Let's continue our lesson in geography. We are doing agriculture and we have reached food security. In our previous class also, we have talked about food security. We have learned the two components of food security are buffer stock and PDS system. Buffer stock means the government has to store some food grains. There should be sufficient. Surplus food grains are stored and some are exported, and after storing, when the granaries are full, then they will export. The government will export the food grains. But first, the government has to maintain the buffer stock. Buffer stock means the stock has to be maintained so that the stock can last for another year. So now, the buffer stock, that means to store the food grains, and the second component is the PDS system, public distribution system, especially for the poor. So now here we'll talk about PDS system. Buffer stock we have talked about. Buffer stock is maintained by FCI, Food Corporation of India. They purchase the food grains from the farmers, big landlords and farmers. They purchase the food grains at a minimum support price, MSP, which is fixed by the government before. So we'll talk about that now. Number two, the second components of food security, the public distribution system. PDS, public distribution system, is a program. It's a program which provide food grains and other essential commodities to the poor. Food grains and essential commodities such as kerosene oil, pulses, sugar, wheat, to the poor at a subsidized rate. Subsidized means reduced prices. Subsidized prices, reduced prices in rural and urban areas. Because most of the people in rural and urban areas are poor. Many poor people are there. They could not afford to purchase food grains in the market, because the market price is very high. So they are unable to purchase food grains from the market because the prices are high. So the government helps them through PDS system so that they will get the food grains and other essential items, commodities, for their survival at a subsidized rate, minimum rate or reduced prices. Now, number two, food security is a policy of the government that makes sure, ensure means make sure, you know, that ensure availability of food grains to the common poor people at an affordable price, so that they could afford, so that they could purchase at a lower rate, subsidized rate. So that food is available to even to the poorest people. FCI, we have talked about Food Corporation of India. They have to maintain the buffer stock. Food Corporation of India, FCI means, is responsible. FCI is responsible for procuring means purchasing, or purchasing and stocking food grains. They have to store, they have to maintain the stock. They have to keep the record. So it is the responsible of the FCI to store food grains, maintain stock. Distribution of food grains is ensured by PDS system. You can see the two components, FCI, they purchase and store and maintain the stock, and distribution system, PDS system, is another system that will see the distribution of the food grains, especially to the poor and common people. FCI purchases the food grains from the farmers at a minimum support price. The price is fixed by the government before cultivation, before cropping, and some amount is also provided to the farmers so that it will help them to do their farming, or to help to purchase fertilizer, insecticide, seeds for irrigation and so on. So that is minimum support price, which is paid, or the price fixed by the government. the government will have an agreement with the farmers. You sell the food grains to me, to the government, FCI, at this rate. So the farmers get ready. Suppose if the government is paying 10 rupees kg for wheat, suppose a wheat, the government wants to purchase wheat, the government will fix a price. I will purchase your wheat at 10 rupees per kg. Suppose. And in the market, when the production, when they harvest the crop, and if the market price is 8 rupees, the government is already paying them 10 rupees, so they are in a profit, they will make money. And if the government is paying 10 rupees, and if the market price is 12 rupees, they will be at a loss. But it is not a loss, because the government will provide them subsidies for many other things, such as fertilizer, insecticide, irrigation, electricity, so many subsidies for each and everything. So at a, naturally they will be at a profit. They will never have a loss. They will never get lost, or they will not suffer any losses. So the government will support them. The minimum support price. Along with that, government will provide other inputs at a subsidized rate. So naturally the farmers will be they will have a profit. So FCI purchases the grains from the farmers at a minimum support price, MSP. If anybody asks you what is MSP, you have to answer minimum support price. One word answer might be there. MSP is a price that is fixed by the government before cropping, before cultivation, before cropping. And the amount is paid to the farmers. Some amount is paid to the farmers beforehand so that it will help them to do their cultivation. So amount is paid to the farmers so that they could invest in crop production. So that they could invest in crop production. So they require some labors, and the labor have to be paid. Since most of the farmers, they do not have then and there, the money is not there in their hand, the money may be in the bank, but the government will provide them so that they can use that money for crop production. So in this way, there is a good coordination between the farmers and the government. Then only food security can be achieved. So buffer stock and PDS system, two components, and they work tandemly. The government and the farmers, they work side by side so that food security or food stock can be maintained, food security can be maintained. So in our next class, we'll talk about something more. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching and listening attentively, and being paying so much attention and being present in the class also. Thank you very much. We'll meet in the next class.